Prepare for battle.
That's the spirit!
I'm starting to analyze the replay of a strong spirit player. He's called, his name Choco. I just made a post on Reddit about it. क्या आप में से कोई कॉल करता है तो एक ड्रॉप होता रहता है?
पता नहीं कौन ड्रॉप हुआ है,
खुद ही हुआ था ना। वाओ सामा,
क्या
पिलाने लग रहे हो? पिलाने
चले, मैं खेल रहा हूँ।
नमाज पढ़ ली?
हाँ। अच्छा। अल्लाह हाफिज़। So I'm just starting to analyze this storm spirit over here. Let's see what he does. See how the game goes. I mean, one thing about blast hitting is you can always improve it. I myself am not really good blast hitter, so there's always room for improvement.
Mine!
I don't think I need to comment on that. It's just about how much I on this type of thing. For now, he's doing fun. Let's see what the blast hitting noise are. Then look around just to denies for denies. He's focusing more on denies more than last pick. I guess in the beginning you should focus more on the last pick. I like how he's pressuring and punishing the invoker when he comes into the tower. He pushes him back. I think I may have a replay back here, so I'll just restart the replay because it's I guess it's fine for now. Let's see. Now, I guess I'm going to restart my Dota or something. Replay bug is gone now because it was showing the cell, so I did not really want to continue like that. Oh, I have to select one spare. Okay, I guess we were here. So he punished the invoker right here, which was pretty good. He saved him there, he shot me, so he went uphill and shot him there and went back. That's pretty good. Okay, so over here, Well, you did, Bossy, then you threw the car away. It took a lot of damage and then basically took a tall because of that. I think he almost died, I guess. Okay, the Sunstrike missed, but he could have died there. That was a bad move. You shouldn't run into the tower just like that. If you're not sure if you can kill the person, because the players invoking can always force snap you and just punish you like he did over there.
Gold for me.
He got another fire from the courier, so he used that. Last hit in the 9.
It's gonna be Hook Central!
He didn't find the rune top, so he's looking for the rune bottom now. But took it. So he's back in the lane. Now focusing on the last hit in my victim. Did he see Pudge hit here? Let's see what he does.
Denied!
So right now he's just running back. By just level 2, he could probably hit him. Hit him there once. He's just... He has good math awareness looking at his faces, looking very what he was fighting. I'm not sure where the Pudge is right now. Let's check. The Pudge probably... Okay, the first TP button. That's good. So over here, you could probably get Invoker with your spirit. But he'd used it a little bit. He could do it earlier and get some hits from the creeps. Shouldn't go low ground and then give him both the 3 hits after that. You just have to chase him off and then back and then take him.
Denied!
You harass him again. And now he knows the cause. Invoker knows. He has the advantage right now because Storm is really low, he's just really scared to go for the last hits. So that's what Storm should do.
Denied!
But Invoker is doing right now.
Amazing what you find laying around.
He could fight down and then he just start to use a spirit and then hit it with him with the overload. And just back off, not go to the low ground and get shot. Shots by the priest and then by Invoker and hit low. Again, he could use an overload right there. He took a 3 hit from the Invoker.
Denied!
If Invoker is getting this much aggressive, you should try to harass him as much as possible. Just use your first spell and hit him with the overload. It does a lot of damage. It slows him down. And if Invoker switches aggro over there, creeps would hit him too. So that's really good.
Amazing what you found lying around.
So he found an illusion rune here.
Illusion? Precious bounty.
Now you have the, do you have the bottle? You also have a shrine ready, so you should probably harass him a little bit. Where? You can go in now because he doesn't have the spells. And then. Okay, he tried for it, but Invoker was being close spot and ran away. I guess if he was a little faster, he could have killed him, but I don't think that's like a mistake, but it's just. You just need a lot of practice on the hero to be able to do that, but I think he did the right thing punishing the Invoker over there.
Missing middle!
Another thing I
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Bombs, like you're using your mouse to take these ability points. I think the better way is to just use the hotkey. I'm not sure where the hotkey is. Yeah, the learn ability hotkey helps a lot in some cases. When you're in a fight or something and you level up and you have to take your ulti for instance, and then instead of moving your mouse over here and then leveling it up, you could just use the hotkey for the learn ability and get it faster, which can help you sometimes run away from some situations. Just needs a little bit of practice, but it's really helpful. Again, you could harass Invoker a little bit here and then go back to your shrine. Because you're pretty low and they also have the Bloodseeker. So they cannot see you all.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Jaya's
middle tower is under attack.
I am first.
You should have
everything.
Just run to the shrine from here and then just use that up.
Gold for me.
Now you should again harass. You should just jump into him. Use your bottle charges. With new TP, you could just use bottle charges. I think 2 bottle charges instantly and it would still refill it itself. But let's doing less
for me.
For the amount of. Over here, you could again jump onto the Invoker when he was doing that instead of going for the because he would deny it. Then, because of that storm, wasted all his bottle. Now we have half of his mana. Again, you're standing on the low ground, Invoker's just hitting you freely. You don't want that. There's point of the game and Wolf has a lot of damage and he can almost all this. Over here you should punish Invoker again. You should have just jumped on him and used the overlord, lowered him up so the tower can hit him at least 2 or 3 times. And you also had a sentry here so you couldn't really do a swap, so you could also use your first spell and then hit him with an overlord.
Precious bounty!
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Ha-ha!
I'll take that.
I'm just trying to go out and go to stomping and fast at this moment right now. You used the clarity and you shifted your
head. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I'm not sure about the maths over here. I'm not sure if with the new path has more intelligence but give you more mana regeneration like this, but I think the better way would be to keep your heads on agility and maybe try to keep the null talisman in your dark head for a while.
Over here now! Over here!
Okay, that's a good point. He just punished him and good. Invoker can't really ghost pop at the city over there, so it was a really good move from the snow.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Double kill!
Missing middle!
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
The twins. Amazing what you'll find laying around.
You just wasted all your mana because of that reason to do that on that.
I don't
because of that jump to the right, the next my high ground also wasted your regeneration. You could just stay on the high ground.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Maybe help Tango with the punch if you had.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified.
Let you start, but...
Dire's middle tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Precious bounty.
Moving towards the bottom, but there's already your kill, but there's...
Here I am!
Dire's top tower is under attack.
There was only a Bloodseeker here. Now they don't have any vision. So four of them moving bottom circle here. I'm gonna use it. No, why not?
Let the fun begin!
And if you want to use DK, you should just jump on them. You should cancel his DP jump on them.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
But still, if you can still listen to it.
Radiant's structures are fortified. Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is
fortified.
Okay, he's okay, so you're doing this and I'll probably hit him.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Got a lot of gold from those kills.
Dire's structures are fortified.
You have... Okay, you're using clarity, so that's good.
I'll take that.
Coin for me.
Stupendous!
I mean, in these situations, what you could probably do is...
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Use the room, the buff portal, so you get out of the
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Looking for me?
Illusion.
Oh, what I missed!
Touché! So, Hero's part of the room decided not to fight for him and fight after the decision. Maybe you could still hit him once with your overlord because you had it already, and then jump to the
fight. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
At your base, you should spam the button. That's really good. Again, after you should always use your bottle because it kills when you're coming from your fountain. You can use one or two powers instantly, which would save you, I think, 100-150 mana. Right now, there's a level 30 here. But you can still jump on the Enigma over there. You have a lot of mana and the Enigma special there. You can jump there and get out from there. Sven's stun was already used. Let's go back there and see what... Sven has... Okay, the Sven's stun is used. He sees the Enigma over there. He has only 3 HP. He has 1 power. He could just jump in here, kill him, and then get out. Have a cookie. And Enigma is still free. He could still jump on it. They wouldn't come for that. Sven was not there. They used Cold Snap too, so they had no mana to contest the Storm killing the Enigma over there. He also had no Black Hole. If they did not have Enigma there, maybe they wouldn't have even come for the Witch Doctor after the first kill. He's just farming for his origin right now.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
I haven't seen any fights. 60 from far. Nice.
You had your warning!
Under attack.
Now he's low on mana. So you can't really contest this when taking the tower. Now he should be looking for more kills after the orchid.
Gold for me!
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Okay, he's dead.
Dire's bottom tower has been denied.
Now he has a lot of mana, he sees the Enigma there. I don't think there's anyone else there. He should still jump because he can jump out anytime. I don't think at this MMR they would have good reflexes to this black hole. But he could have used, and he also had the orchid, so there was no chance to black hole. He could have killed the Enigma over there, but he decided to not go for it. I mean, even if they jump on you, you can spell it.
Wooden pop! Jump out. Over here now! Let the fun begin!
Oh! Now he has no mana. I can go crystal there and he's taking last hit inside the tower range. I think they should crystal that. Now go for zap! He sees that when.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Didn't you get the code?
Dire's destruction or forced by the Aegis.
You should be alert for that. But no, nevertheless.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Radiant's
top tower.
Okay, he can jump right now. He has a lot of mana. Storm's jump is pretty. He can reach there.
Coin for me.
Just one there. But he decided to walk.
Precious bounty.
Quench kill right now is the biggest kill, I guess. Yeah, he has almost the same net worth as the Bloodseeker, so it would have been a huge kill if he could just jump there and just kill him.
Over here!
Chopping up double damage!
He has a Yule Scepter, but you could probably go for the invoke if it was for the tier 2.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
You can just jump on the invoker right now because he knows they don't have Upset. You can just silence the invoker and go on the invoker.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
But he's still hiding in the tier 2.
Here I am!
Now he goes for the Blight Scepter. But now he's out of mana, I can't do anything.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
He still gets the kill that time, but I think the better kill would have been the inside over here. Because that was a definite kill, I think. Okay. That would have been easily guaranteed with the orchid in the jump damage.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Amazing what you found lying around.
But I don't think there was anything else there.
Precious bounty.
Let's start for 15 seconds.
That's exact.
Precious bounty.
Dire are scanned.
Ho ho! Here I am!
I don't think you can jump this one again. You should always use all your mana if you're trying to do that. So you have like more mana to use yourself. But at this point of the game, I don't think it's worth it.
I'm over here!
And a jump can kill us when at full HP, SP, 600 HP, SP.
Freakily go!
And now he's just going back to the base. He still has his.
Glorious thanks!
Catching the Blood Eater is not really helpful because it doesn't take the Blood Eater. But right now, he could just jump on the Blood Eater.
I am the
He could still jump.
Thank you.
Let the fun begin.
Focus is not getting his blood
from. Zip!
He still has his blood from ability. I don't think.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's structures are fortified. Zap!
Also, you get the new patch that you can change the tower damage so you get more mana resources.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
In with Storm you can be accepted because you have the mystery spell and then you have the I don't think he needs to go mad right now. If I just farm the jungle like this, if I can then go mad because the fight is over.
Whoa, what I miss? Whoa, what I miss?
And he's also going to get mad, which would give him a lot of mana reason. He's probably going to sell his Null Talisman and get the Bloodstone. Yeah, he does that. I think it's been 15 minutes since his boots are still on agility.
Zip!
Well, I don't think
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
If he was more carefully,
Dire's top tower has fallen.
Zap!
Now I'm okay.
Over here now! Over here now! Looking for me! Button pop!
Really easy to run away with the Storm Spirit. You can bait them, bait the stunts and everything. And then just run away, but you could, you should just on any
coin for me.
Every single target stunting there.
Nip away from this! Dominating. Elemental gold. Invisibility.
Where's the party?
So I think at this point of the game, Storm Spirit can only upon the Enigma given other heroes are really fun. Maybe the Pudge, but Pudge has
nothing. Dire's bottom shrine is under attack.
Here I am!
Dire's bottom shrine has fallen. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Because you can contest this, so you should try to fall.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Zap! Ho-ho!
Then, because you don't have half mana, you can just go to the fountain, refill yourself up and then...
Couldn't pop! Here I am! Zip!
You also have a TP ready. They're just standing there.
There's a restaurant.
Right, standing
missing bottom.
You could get from all these caves over here, and if you manage to reach this thing, you could.
Oh, what did I miss?
Make them TP back to their towers to defend them, and then you can TP back to your jungle and then farm the city.
Yeah. Zap!
Gold for me.
Over here now.
Zip zap! I don't think the BKB is useful in this game.
Zap!
You have a really good escape mechanism and they don't... the only magic damage I see over
here. Roshan has fallen to the ring.
Immortality.
So if you can dodge those spells. So if you go a link in the start of the TKB,
Dire's top shrine is under attack. Some-
Fine.
Where's the party?
You could probably just run away whenever you get rocket by us in this spell. Probably the most scary would be Swinstone, which you could dodge, or Enigma Snap.
Dire's top shrine has fallen.
Looking for me?
Dire's middle shrine has fallen.
I'm over here.
Where you going?
Dire structures are fortified.
Touché.
Dire's middle belt.
Now he is back on the next one.
You blew it!
He could also focus on the meter over there. He was almost alone. There was a blood seeker back there, but.
Over here now!
Dire's bottom tower.
Blow the man down!
Dire's bottom barracks are under attack.
I'm over here! Zip!
Radiant structures are fortified.
Here I am!
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Looking for me? Let the fun begin!
Radiant's bottom tower is being
demolished.
Ah!
The whole grenade!
Invoker the spot, but if they can punish this invoker buyback, they could probably do some haste damage, maybe get a rax.
I'm
not sure why he bought it.
Dude, your storm was coming!
Gold on this item and he's not really using it. He could probably spend it on the legend sphere earlier, which would have helped him.
Whoa, what I miss?
Mana pool and mana
elemental gold.
And could also just go blood pawn and stuff.
Over here now!
So now he's just trying to farm the legend sphere. And now
illusion.
He's trying to put the BKB on.
Here I am! Let the fun begin!
He uses the BKB on when he pops. The moment he bought it.
Dire's bottom
I guess he just probably wasted 4,000 gold.
Dire's structures are fortified.
Zap. Maybe.
Dyer's top barracks
are under attack. Extra barracks over here. We could have a link to the last of the last one.
Dyer's top barracks has fallen. Dyer's top barracks has fallen. The race now has
Where's
negative.
The body? Looking for me?
Dyer's middle tower is under attack. Dyer's middle tower is under attack. Has
failed. Oh, I don't think they have to analyze.
Here I am!
Come
on, let the fun begin!
Put it in the inventory, but now the Kai is not in his inventory. Kai is like, it gives you the moment for the life.
For the twins.
I'm over here!
Zack
and his goal! Illusion!
Here I am! Where's the party?
See this way for
2,000. I'm over here!
I think he could just sell it and just buy something else because it's not really needed.
Dyer's engine is under attack.
Visibility!
So I guess the biggest mistake was buying the BKB. They were very small mistakes with not jumping on heroes when the storm could really jump on them and kill them, get some pickoffs, maybe save his teammates. Other than that, the laning stage, you could always improve on that. Items were almost fine, there was nothing. What else could he go? He could probably go for a Shiva's guard to T-push. So he bought the BKB at 38 minutes. So for 10 minutes he did not use his BKB. And then he got Lincoln's at minute 45. He could have a Lincoln's here and then probably Bloodthorn somewhere here, and then he could probably fight them with that. I think this was the biggest mistake in the game. There were other mistakes, as I pointed, for jumps on heroes he could get, but he did not. He just stayed back. I guess that's it.